Of course, as we continue to work together, we must also negotiate the UK's successful exit from the European Union. This will take time, and it will require serious and detailed work. But as long as we are a member of the EU, we will respect the rights and obligations of membership. I want to work with Chancellor Merkel and my colleagues around the European Council in a constructive spirit to make this a sensible and orderly departure. All of us will need time to prepare for these negotiations, and the United Kingdom will not invoke Article 50 until our objectives are clear. And that's why I have said already this will not happen before the end of this year. I understand this timescale will not please everyone, but I think it is important to provide clarity on that now. We should strive for a solution which respects the decision of British voters, but also respects the interests of our European partners. Together, we should maximise the opportunities for both the UK and the EU. And to conclude, I said recently that the United Kingdom should not be defined exclusively by the process of our withdrawal from the EU, nor should it define our relationships with countries around the world. Of course, there are challenges ahead and much to be worked through, but I do believe that upon leaving the European Union, the United Kingdom can forge strong and successful relationships with European countries, and that those relationships can benefit not just Britain, but our partners too. And as we embark on that new chapter, I look forward to working with you, Chancellor, to develop that successful partnership.